In this example, I'm going to look at a packed bed catalytic reactor in which the conversion is 40%. We want to make the reactor 50% bigger, namely increase the size to 1/2 times the original size in order to increase productivity, but we're limited in what pressures we can use on both the upstream and the downstream side. So we cannot change the feed pressure or the exit pressure. The pressure drop remains the same. And the question is, how much does the conversion increase for this first order reaction? So we're going to solve it using polymath. There are other screencasts that describe in more detail the equation for pressure drop in a packed bed reactor. We're using the Ergen equation, which is indicated here. This tells how the pressure drops as a function of distance to the reactor and number of variables that I won't go into detail here. The size of particles are small, 2 times 10 to the minus 3 meters, and that causes significant pressure drop. And so I've picked values to give us 40% conversion. And then the second part is the mass balance for first order reaction. Just A goes to B, constant temperature. And again, I've picked values to make this comparison easy. And so what we want to look at is how the pressure drops. Comes in at 12 bar, leaves at 8 bar. The molar flow rate of our reactant A decreases, as we expect. The volumetric flow rate increases because of the decreased pressure. And this is the conversion that goes from 0 to 40%. Well, what we want to do is compare it now when the reactor is 50% longer. However, when we make the reactor 50% longer, we have to change other things. And so, most importantly, we have to decrease the feed rate in order to have the same pressure drop for this longer reactor. Just by solving the polymath equation for a few conditions, I determined this is the feed rate of A that will give us the same outlet pressure as for our 14-meter reactor. Then we have to change also the mass flow rate. So the mass flow rate is proportional to the molar flow rate with molecular weight, of course. And notice this is kilograms per second. So the mass flow rate is decreased from the value in the shorter reactor. And then the total molar flow rate is decreased. And in this particular program, because of the way it's set up, that changed that in a few places. So what happens? Well, the 21-meter reactor were set up to have the same pressure drop. We picked the conditions to make that happen. Well, the molar flow rate coming in is lower, and of course it coming out is even lower because we have more reaction time. The volumetric flow rate increases perhaps 50% in this case. And the conversion is what we're most interested in. So instead of 40% conversion, we have around 60% conversion. If we had a reactor with no pressure drop, we'd certainly, for a first-order reaction, we would not see the conversion increase from 40% to 60% because the concentration is lower in that last part of the reactor, so the rate is lower for a first-order reaction. However, we have several things changing, and one of them is that we have a slower flow rate coming in, which increases residence time in the reactor, and so we actually increase the conversion by about 50%. The actual flow rate of product, however, we increase from 0.103 moles per second. This is the flow rate of our product B to 0.127. So about 25% increase in the molar flow rate as we make the reactor 1.5 times as long, but keep the pressure drop constant.